Greetings to all. Today, I am Riyadhmi pursuing BLLB is going to talk about impact of COVID-19 on our Indian economy. The impact of COVID-19 pandemic on Indian economy has been largely disruptive in terms of economic activity as well as a loss of human lives. Almost all the sectors have been adversely affected as domestic demand and exports sharply plummeted, with some notable exemptions where high demand was observed. COVID-19 has been projected as worse than the depreciation of 1930. Indian economy, however, has a slightly different story to tell at this hour of crisis. Attempt has been made to analyze the impact and possible solutions for the key sectors. Firstly, food and agriculture. COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted the Indian agricultural system extensively. Nevertheless, the recent quarterly GDP estimates post-COVID-19 scenario showcased robustness and resilience in Indian agriculture. The only sector to register a positive growth of 3.4% during the financial year 2020-21. At the same time, the immediate past quarter growth was estimated at 5.9%, witnessing a decline by 2.5%. In this context, we aim to synthesize the early evidence of the COVID-19 impact of the Indian agricultural system by production, marketing and consumption, followed by a step of potential strategies to recover and prosper post-pandemic. Secondly, telecom. There had been a significant amount of changes in the telecom sector of the India even before the COVID-19 due to brief price wars between the service providers. Most essential services and sectors have continued to run during the pandemic thanks to the implementation of the work from home due to restrictions. With over 1 billion connections as of 2019, the telecom sector contributes about 6.5% of GDP and employs almost 4 million people. Demand has been increased by about 10%. However, the telcos are bracing for a sharp drop in adding new subscribers. Thirdly, pharmaceuticals. The pharmaceutical industry had been on the rise since the start of the COVID-19 pandemic, especially in India, the largest producer of generic drugs globally. With a market size of $55 during the beginning of 2020, it had been surging in India, exporting hydroxychloroquine to the world, especially to US, UK, Canada and the Middle East. There had been a recent rise in the prices of the raw materials imported from China due to the pandemic. The increasing demand for these drugs, coupled with hindered accessibilities, is making things harder. Easing the financial stress on the pharmaceutical companies, tax relaxations and addressing the labor force shortage could be the differentiating factors in such a desperate time. Fourth, aviation and tourism. The contribution of the aviation sector and tourism to our GDP stands at about 2.4% and 9.2% respectively. The tourism sector served approximately 43 million people in the year 2018-19. The common consensus seems to be that COVID will hit these industries harder. These two industries have been dealing with severe cash flows issues since the start of the pandemic and are staring at a potential 38 million layoffs, which translates to 70% of the total workforce. The impact is going to fall on both white and blue collar jobs. According to IATO estimates, these industries may incur losses of about 85 billion rupees due to travel restrictions. The pandemic has also brought about a wave of innovation in the fields of contactless boardings and travel technologies. Fifth, oil and gas. The Indian oil and gas industry is quite significant in the global context. It is the third largest energy consumer only behind USA and China and contributes to 5.2% of the global oil demand. The complete lockdown across the country showed down the demand of transport fuels as auto and industrial manufacturing declined and goods and passenger movements